Hello, welcome at the Victron Energy Tech Talk episode 2. Here we will try to answer as many product related questions that you might have. The first comment we received was from Mark Pingle, and he says, "This Tech Talk format is pretty cool. I'm also happy you finally have comments enabled." Thank you very much, Mark. The thing on comments is, by the way, that please keep them as short as possible, because the longer questions that you have, system related questions, actually you should go to the community, the Victron community. The small product related questions you can leave here. But first, something else. A couple of weeks ago, we had a photo contest for our upcoming calendar. So we have asked to send in your photo of your Victron system with your animal of pet. The winner is the Tiny House Academy, a customer of Top Systems in the Netherlands. Congratulations, your prize will be handed out soon. So the first technical question is coming from Samuel, and Samuel is asking, the 30 amp blue smart charger with three outputs, how many amps does one output produce? Well, the answer, Samuel, is actually quite simple, because the 30 amp charger can divide its current over the three outputs. So a single output can handle 30 amps, but if the other outputs also draw current, let's say 10 amps, then there's 20 amps spare for the first one. So in total it's 30 amps, and then how the current is divided is depending on the loads which you have connected to these outputs. Another question is coming from Carl. Carl is asking, I have two AGM 105 amp hour batteries in my boat. They are about 5 years old, but I think in really good shape. Can I add some extra batteries to this? Can I mix AGM and GEL? Do they have the same amp hour rating? The answer is no. You shouldn't mix and match old and new batteries, and certainly not of different capacities or different chemistries. So a battery bank is combined as one when you install it, and you should leave it at that. If you need more capacity, well, I'm sorry to tell you, but then you need a whole new battery bank. The next question is on DC-DC converters. Christian is asking, isolated or non-isolated Orion DC-DC converters, when to use the one and when to use the other? Isolated DC-DC converter means actually that the minus is in common of the input and the output. That means that noise, which is happening on the input, is also traveling through the device to the output. So if you have a sensitive VHF radio or other measurement equipment and you want to have a clean power, then you use an isolated one. If you have no need for an isolation, then you can use the non-isolated one. In general, the isolated one is a more expensive DC-DC converter than the non-isolated one. Some extra, on the latest firmware, there is something called engine detection mode on. And engine detection mode means that you can have a set point on the input, and if the set point is below a certain voltage, then the output is also reduced. That means if you have a DC-DC converter running on an alternator, then it can detect if the alternator is running or not. So when the voltage is dropping from your alternator, because it's idling or it's because it's switched off, then also the output is throttled down, if needed, to zero. If you want to have this on your smart DC-DC converter, then you have to make sure that you download firmware 5.05 or higher. Next question is coming from Jeff. Jeff is asking how to disable the float voltage on a solar charger for lithium type batteries. After the absorption is over, disable the charge until below a rebulk voltage. Well, the answer is quite simple, Jeff. You can lower the float voltage to a level which is lower than a full battery voltage. That means that the charger at that point will not charge the battery anymore. On the other hand, the float voltage also has a purpose, and that's to be as power supply. That means if your charger stops charging, you still want to have the loads supplied by energy from your charger. That means the float voltage should also be a little bit higher than your full battery voltage, because otherwise you will drain your battery again. The final question for this episode is coming from Arthur, and Arthur is asking, hi, how many MPPTs can one connect to the same solar array? Well, quite simple, Arthur, only one, because you can of course connect more MPPTs to it, but then the efficiency will become very low. So an MPPT is searching for the optimal power point for that panel, and if you include more MPPTs on the same panel, they get confused by each other, so never do that. So the maximum is per array one MPPT solar charger. That was all for this episode. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, you can leave them on the community page. And if they're short, you can also leave them in the comment bar below. Bye.